Hi everyone! At the end of January, we went on a day trip to Machu Somes Island, which is a 25-minute ferry ride from Queen's Wharf out into Wellington Harbour. The island is named for the daughter of the Polynesian explorer Kupe. The name of the island was changed to Somes Island in 1839, renamed for the governor of the New Zealand Company. In 1997, the dual name Machu Somes Island was assigned by the New Zealand Geographic Board. In more recent times, the island was used as a quarantine facility for both humans and animals. The island was an internment camp in both world wars. Gun emplacements and a degaussing station to protect ships against magnetic mines were installed on the island during World War II. It was an amazingly hot day, although not quite as hot as the ferry trip we took last year in January over to Days Bay. We caught the 10 a.m. ferry and sat up the top because I knew the sunshine would be blistering hot on our 3 p.m. trip back to Wellington. The trip over was lovely and we even saw a pod of dolphins. When the boat arrived at Somes Island Dock and we disembarked, we had to check our bags in case pests such as mice had hitched a ride. Then it was off up the main path towards the Somes Island Visitors Centre. It was gull breeding season on the island and we were warned that we might be dive bombed by the adult seagulls. We did see quite a few nests and were vocally warned off by the adults, but luckily none of the birds dive bombed us. Also lots of tiny orange butterflies among the shrubs along the track, which I had never seen before. I think they might have been New Zealand copper butterflies. They were very tiny and very pretty. Once we reached the top of the path, we found the quarantine station. We kept on up past the station into the sheep paddocks on the island. There were World War II gun emplacements to explore at the top of the island, but we kept on fairly quickly as there was very little shade and also swarms of very small insects that constantly landed on everyone and everything. We walked out of the bright sunshine down into the bush again and made our way around the side of the island to find a place for lunch. We came across these two baby gulls with their parents. The parents flew away and left the babies to fend for themselves, so we waited quietly to see what would happen. Eventually, a group of people came along the track from the other direction, and the baby seagulls scuttled back past us to keep out of the way of the new group of people. I think they were reunited with their parents back down the track. We found a lookout with a seat, so we sat down to have lunch and enjoy the view across the harbour and towards the historic lighthouse. Thank you. lighthouse on the island was built in 1900 and replaced the original one built in 1866, which was the first harbour lighthouse in New Zealand. After the visit to the lighthouse, we kept on the circuit and made our way back towards the top of the island. We set up all our stuff at a picnic table under a tree. Then I had a quick look in the visitor's centre, which had some very interesting displays on the history of the island and also the plants and animals living on the island. After this, I headed back to the picnic table and set up to do a little bit of drawing. The breeze was a nice relief from the heat. This little blackbird, as well as a chaffinch, were very curious and hung out the entire time I was drawing. Occasionally, the blackbird jumped onto the picnic table to get a better look. Okay, we've made it to a picnic table spot, and I've got my sketchbook, I've got a drink, I'm going to get my pencil case out, so I can do some sketching. There's a really interesting looking tree over here. Let me just see if I can show you. So I thought I might try and sketch the bark on this tree here. Could be a fun thing to do. So yeah, just going to have a nice chill time doing some sketching for a bit before we have to head back to the boat. One bird that I was sad to not get any good footage of was the kakariki. I was so happy to see these beautiful bright green parrots all over the island, I just wish I'd been faster with my camera. Drawing break, it was nearly time to head down to the boat. We stopped off at the quarantine facility and had a quick look inside. Thank you. continued our walk down to the dock and then went a little bit further to the historic degaussing station. In 1944, this station was manned by two women from the RENS, or Women's Royal New Zealand Navy Service. Any ships leaving Wellington Harbour were decoused to protect them from magnetic mines. Mrs. Meg Pilcher was one of the two RENS, and by using this hand-cranked audio device near the remains of the degaussing station, you can hear in her own words how she applied and got into the Navy.
I first heard about the RENS reading a poster, and I wondered what they were. Obviously, it was something to do with the Navy, and I thought, well, I'd like to have a look at that. So I took down the address and wrote away, and a few weeks later, I got a letter asking me to go to Napier to be interviewed. When I went into the office, there was a tall lady there, and we chatted away for a little while, and she saw you were a country girl. And I said, yes. And then she said, and what do you think you can offer the Navy? And I said, well, I can do semaphore and Morse code. Oh, and where did you learn that? So I told her in the girl guides. It wasn't until quite a lot later that I learned she was commissioner of girl guides for New Zealand. But I'm sure that helped me get into the Navy. Then she asked me my age, and I said, I'm 17 and a bit. Oh, well, you're far too young. We don't take you in until you're 18. But we could use your signalling talents. About a week after I turned 18, I had another letter asking me to report at a certain day and a certain time to Wellington. I was met in a Navy car taking to Wellington Combined Headquarters, where a big sturdy sailor said, come on, we'll test you. And he tested with my semaphore, which I passed. Then I did the Morse code on the little button thing that one used in those days. And he ignored me totally and turned to the officer and said, oh, she's quite good, she can go on duty tonight. And I thought, but where? I won't go into all the details, but I was hastily taken to two or three places to get shoes, stockings, coat, hat, and smock. And I went on duty at 6 o'clock that night.
Then it was time to head home. We got back on the boat and sat inside on the way home so we would be out of the sunshine. Thanks very much for watching this vlog. I hope you enjoyed this visit to Soames Island with me. Thank you also very much to my patrons. See you next time, have a wonderful day, and I will be back again soon with more art. Bye everyone!